Hey there, I'm Mike, and today I'm going to show you how to easily check and upgrade your MySQL. Your database more than likely runs on MySQL or its fully open source fork, MariaDB. Unfortunately, not all hosts will continue to keep it up to date, so it's often up to you to check your MySQL version and keep it upgraded. Outdated software on your server is never good and can also be harmful. In this video, we'll learn how to check if your MySQL version is up to date and upgrade it if it's not. But before we get too far, I want to let you know that there'll be links to more resources in the video's description. And remember, subscribe and ring that bell to get notifications for future helpful content. Now, let's do this. Many servers these days are still running on MySQL 5.7, even though a newer and better version exists. So, which is best, MySQL 5.7 or 8.0? Most people don't upgrade because either they don't know about the latest MySQL version or they don't want to take the time to update it. In addition, 5.7 has not been depreciated and will not be until 2023. But while MySQL 5.7 is still supported, making the switch to the latest version is definitely worth your time. It's faster and more secure, and changes can be observed instantly upon activating it. And for developers who can make use of the new functions, the benefits are more numerous than can be quickly listed. There are some upgrade considerations and backward incompatibilities you'll need to know about, but for a majority of sites, they won't cause any issues. It's almost always best to keep up with the latest stable version of MySQL. Even minor updates are worth the trouble, though the new built-in auto-updater will likely handle those for you. As for major updates, it's worth it unless crucial parts of your server are incompatible. While WordPress supports MySQL versions all the way back to 5.6, 8.0 works perfectly with it. And as 5.6 is no longer supported and is susceptible to bugs and security risks, you should at least update to 5.7. Accessing your database and checking your MySQL version with MyKinsta is very easy. There are several ways to do so, but the easiest two are using phpMyAdmin or connecting with the command line. You can find phpMyAdmin after logging into MyKinsta. Just go to Sites, then Info, and under the Database Access section, click Open phpMyAdmin. The credentials you need to log in are right there. You can also connect with the command line with SSH. With Kinsta, we set up everything for you to allow SSH access. Just find your credentials in Sites and then Info in the SFTP SSH section. Then follow these next steps to log in and put in the proper commands. The easiest way to obtain MySQL version is with a simple code submitted through the command line. It takes mere seconds and answers your question instantly. Getting at your server's command line shouldn't be too difficult unless you're using minimal hosting. There are a variety of ways to access your server's command line. For example, your web host may provide a way to submit commands through their backend, such as with cPanel. Or you may be able to use the built-in terminal or command prompt to connect to your server. Tools like PuTTY also exist to help you log in and are usually required for Windows users to connect with SSH. Either way, you'll need some SSH login credentials. You can usually find them in your web hosting dashboard, or you can email them and ask for help. Once you know how you're going to connect to your server's command line, follow these steps. Step 1, launch the terminal or command prompt on your computer. In cPanel, you can find it under Advanced and then Terminal. Step 2, provide your SSH credentials to connect and log into the server. Step 3, input the following command. If you have the MySQL shell installed, you can also use the simple command MySQL to show your version information. Either way, the version number should be output on the screen. There's another straightforward way to check your MySQL version, and that's with phpMyAdmin. This software is also ubiquitous and present on most servers, so you have a good shot at finding your MySQL version. Find your phpMyAdmin credentials by checking your web hosting dashboard. There may be even a direct link to log in there. Email your host if you can't find them. Log in to phpMyAdmin once you find your credentials. As soon as you're in, you'll see a database server box on the right side of the screen. There, under the software version section, is your MySQL version. Easy as that. A final easy way to find your MySQL version is through your site's WordPress admin dashboard. To do that, visit your WordPress dashboard and go to Tools, then Site Health. Under there, first go to the Info tab and then to the Database section below. You can find your server's current MySQL version listed here beside the server version label. If you've determined your MySQL is out of date, you should rectify that as soon as possible. There are multiple ways to update MySQL to the latest versions. It all depends on what tools and operating systems you're using. It's worth noting that later versions of MySQL will attempt to auto-update if the script notices that your installation is out of date. You may not need to do anything at all. If you determine that MySQL is out of date and needs to be manually updated, follow these steps. Like checking your MySQL version with the command line, you'll need to obtain your SSH login credentials from your web host to access the terminal on your server. And of course, you'll need the IP address of your server. Before updating MySQL, make sure to back up your database. For Kinsta users, it's elementary to do so in MyKinsta. Log in and go to Sites and then Backups. You'll find a downloadable zip file there. This backup contains both your database, an SQL file, and your entire site, so you'll be extra safe if something goes wrong. If your host offers cPanel, it's probably the easiest way to do an upgrade since you can use the interface provided. But since cPanel defaults to MySQL 5.7 by default, you may want to do an upgrade. As cPanel doesn't allow you to downgrade, you should back up your database before proceeding. Most cPanel installations come with Web Host Manager, which gives you deeper root access. Step 1, log into WHM by going to your site/WHM. You can also ask your web host how to access WHM specifically. Step 2, navigate to Software and then MySQL Upgrade or type in MySQL into the search bar. You may also find it under SQL Services and then MySQL MariaDB Upgrade. Step 3, select the version of MySQL you want to upgrade to and then click Next. Now follow the upgrade steps. It'll take care of everything for you. This method is by far the simplest way to do a MySQL upgrade, but if your host doesn't offer cPanel or WHM, you may need to do it manually. There are a variety of Linux distributions, but Ubuntu is by far the most common. These instructions should work for any operating system that uses the apt or apt-get function to install the software. Linux can easily connect through SSH without any additional software requirements, so you can get right to your server. Step 1, launch the terminal. Obtain your SSH credentials and use the SSH command to log in. Step 2, you should have the MySQL apt repository installed since MySQL is already on your server. Update your package list with the following command. Step 3, now upgrade MySQL. You can also try this command if that command doesn't work. It'll prompt you to choose a version, select 5.7 or 8.0. If you're upgrading from 5.6, you should upgrade to 5.7 first, rather than going straight to 8.0. While macOS comes with its own version of MySQL, you can't upgrade it through the usual methods, and most likely your server is using a separate instance. Many of these steps are very similar to updating MySQL on Linux. macOS similarly has SSH built into the operating system, so all you need to do is run the commands. We'll assume you're using Homebrew as a package manager, as it's the simplest way to install and update MySQL on a Mac. You shouldn't attempt to upgrade MySQL with Homebrew if you didn't use it to install it initially. Step 1, launch the terminal program and log in with an SSH command. Step 2, run these commands using Homebrew. This command should automatically install 8.0 and upgrade any existing versions. Are you running into trouble? Try uninstalling the current version of MySQL first. Use these commands. Then you can attempt to run the update and install commands again. Step 3, make sure you start the MySQL server again manually. Unlike Mac and Linux, Windows can't use SSH by default. Instead, you'll need to install a separate client and then you can connect to your server. Step 1, download PuTTY and install it on your system. Launch it and input your SSH credentials and connect to the server. 3306 is the default port number. Ignore any security alerts. These are normal. Step 2, assuming you're connecting to a Linux terminal, you can use these commands to perform the upgrade. You can also use the MySQL installer to download MySQL onto the system directly. This process skips the SSH connection entirely. Kinsta's WordPress hosting can speed up your website by up to 200%, and you'll get 24/7 support from our expert WordPress engineers. Let us show you the Kinsta difference. Try a free demo of our MyKinsta dashboard at demo.kinsta.com. And thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe for more tutorials, explainers, and helpful content like this.